Hi everyone, welcome back to another video. My name is Oluchi Lloyd. Thank you guys for tuning in. So guys, if you are new here, please do us a favor. Before you finish to watch this video, please, please kindly click the subscribe button and also the notification icon. That is when you know whenever I upload a new video so that I can come and check it out. So guys, let's dive into this video. I saw this information yesterday. I shared a video about Asere Dokubo visiting or invited by DSS or whatever they may call DSS. Okay, now there's another information. This one also, I saw it. The headline says that the Afariku-Ibeku people, okay, their villages in Nomaya, the DSS people, they are disturbing them. So I don't know if he's one of those Asere Dokubo's plan and all that. So, according to what says here, okay, the news said that DSS leave us alone. Like the people like protesting. The leader of Indigenous People of Biafra, Mazi Namuyo Dekado, IPOP, is from Afariku-Ibeku in Umuahia North, local government area of Abia State. So, this has made the people, you know, like out of masses and take the streets very peaceful protest. They are protesting in the street. They took the government's house, okay? They took the protest to government house in Omaha. And the reason for this protest is to let the state and the federal government know that the people of the community and the entire community are not members of the IPOP, regardless of the fact that the leader of the handful of the protests were seen carrying a card and also in the community peacefully, and also they also tired to the group, and the DPO also addressed the crowd that urged them to keep going on their protest peacefully. And also, let's know what you think about this in the comment box below, like, share, and the other. Thank you. So what happened is that the people in Afariku-Ibeku, they are protesting. I don't know if it's Asare Dokubo's plan. He is the one that is disturbing that community as usual. And for the matter of fact that I think is the one that also involved of this news came out yesterday, being Saturday, June 2020. So I've been, for the matter of the fact that Asare Dokubo has been doing some underground things in Biafra land always, like all those people kidnapping Oyibo, those you know, Operation Python Dance, Army, DSS, you know, disturbing people's peace. I think is one of them that is making those plans. So the people of Afariku-Ibeku, which is Mazina Dekalu's home in Omaha, so then bring this protest out. Then bring this protest out, okay? Then bring all these protests out, saying, look at, look. Then bring this, what they are saying in that protest that they said that Mazina Dekalu is from Omaha, and they as well is from Omaha. So they don't see the reason why. And they are not member of, many of them are not, of course, not all of them will be member of IPOP. So not member of the, not all of them, of course, will be member of IPOP. And what IPOP means is Organization of People that is agitating for freedom of Biafra, for Biafra Nation. Okay, they are organization. They are the group of people. You know, let's say they are, yes, it's organization that what is seeking for freedom of Indigenous people of Biafra. So that's the meaning of IPOP. So they are seeking for the nation of Biafra. So obviously, it's not all of them that are members. But now they are disturbing the whole community in Omaha. Meanwhile, as I'm talking to you guys now, I'm sure UKC Bazi is still in a isolation center. You guys, I uploaded the video last time when I told you guys that he was COVID. He was positive. COVID-19 positive. So as I'm talking to you guys now, as a matter of fact, he's still in an isolation center. So the DSS people are disturbing the peace of Afarikubeku people. They are disturbing people from Afarikubeku DSS. I don't know what they are looking for. Meanwhile, mostly from the community of Maazi Namodi Kanu. I don't know what they are doing. I don't know what they are doing in those villages. Always Operation Python Dance, Crocodile Smile, etc., etc., etc. So meanwhile, yes, the elders and the youth of Afarikubeku community in Omaha then take their protest to government house to protest, tell them to leave them alone. They are telling the DSS to leave them alone. So that is the reason for the peaceful protest. Yeah, the peaceful protest happened in Afarikubeku, Umahia. Yeah, so they are telling them that they are not member of IPOP, so they should leave their village and their state alone. They should go to Sabusa Forest, and they should go to chase the Boko Harams, those ones in the forest. They should go and chase the herdsmen. They should go and chase the Alamajiris, those ones living inside the bushes and the forest. They should leave their bushes and forests and leave the people living peacefully in their villages, in their communities alone. That is the reason for the protest. So my people, this is what is going on right now as I'm talking to you. This news was published yesterday. So the headline is what I'm analyzing. So let's just know this. We need to know this. We need to know this. We need to keep it in our head. So if you come across this news, pass it on. Okay, pass this information, this particular information to everybody. If you are from that particular place in Southeast and Biafra land, this news needs to be shared so that people will be careful and be aware. And beside that, the only person we know that is always dealing with the Nigerian government when it comes in time of army, militaries, and the soldiers, and all those Operation Python Dance, Crocodile Smile, the person working on the ground with these people is none, no person but Asare Dokubo. He's the only person that always do underground things, you know. We're always doing underground things, and things are so bad. Our people are not, you know, they don't, our people, like, let me just say this, our people, they are not happy about that. They are not really happy. They are not happy. They are not happy. They are not happy. So, my people, yeah. So let me know what you think below. I think it's time for everybody to stand up and fight for their right. Is there's no need of you sitting there, some particular group of people called yourself army or DSS or whatever, we intimidate you for nothing. So you guys have taken a very good step by coming out to protest to the public, you know, asking them to leave you alone. For the matter of fact, you guys did not commit anything. And if Maazi Nnamdi Kanu is the leader of indigenous people of Biafra, if he's the leader of IPOP, does not mean that they should disturb everybody. Yes, that is the truth. They shouldn't disturb you guys because you guys are peaceful people. You never kill anyone. You are not Boko Haram. You are not a henchman, those people, harassing people. You are not, Afarikubeku is not, Omahia is not a Sabusa Forest where they're supposed to take their anger and whatever authority that is given to them to. That's where they're supposed to take their frustration to. So my people, yes, so, this is what I said I want to share with you guys now. Let me know what you think below. Share the video, like the video, and also subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you so much and stay blessed. Bye.